55. 中国日报香港版 Say what you like, but history isn't subjective. 2015年7月22日 commentary 09 Lunai Kill every year. The Hong Kong Book Fair is a big deal. At the 26th edition of the fair, which started last Wednesday and ran until Tuesday, it was estimated that a million people would attend. Many attempt to make the fair political. For example, the website EJ Insight ran a piece by Mark O'Neill with the headline, Book Fair Shows Hong Kong's Special Place in China. Why are we special? Oh, we are the only place in China that has freedom of the press, of all possible quotes. O'Neill presented us with this gem that he got from a secondary school teacher from Shenzhen. There is a range and variety we do not have in Shenzhen. The customs could confiscate the per cases on my way home, but usually they do not. A few paragraphs down O'Neill's piece, Long Yingtai was quoted as saying, Hong Kong is a glowing pearl in the world of China that deserves to be cherished and nourished for its sheen to last. She could not have been less specific, but from the context we know perfectly well what she meant by sheen. In case you do not know who Long is, she is a famous scholar, writer, commentator and also Taiwan's former Minister of Culture. She gave a speech at the fair, the title of which was My Memory is What I Am, hailed as one of the biggest events at this year's Hong Kong Book Fair. It was estimated that around 1,500 people from Hong Kong, the mainland and Taiwan attended her talk. The subject of her talk was remembrance and how different people, even from the same family, have different interpretations of the past. She talked about Taiwan soldiers who fought for the Japanese during World War II, and how official celebrations for the anniversary of China's victory over Japan add insult to these people's injuries. I am not sure why people are so impressed with Lung and her relativism about Lung Yat. It is well known that these points of view have no absolute truth or validity. They have only relative, subjective value according to differences in perception and consideration. One side's victory is usually the other side's devastation. The point is, even during the best periods of Sino-Japanese relations, China has never stopped celebrating its victory in the war against Japanese aggression for fear of upsetting Japan. Lung's discourse is not an isolated incident. Taipei Mayor Carl Wenye has recently stopped people from using a public hall to celebrate China's victory over Japan, saying that Taiwan lost the war. Everyone is entitled to his or her ideology and political views, and Long and Carl Tan call for Taiwan's independence so they like. While I disagree with Lung's views, I disagree even more with her methodology. The weight she attributes to memory is unjustified. She claims that a person is his or her memory, as if this determinism is self-evident. But it is hardly the case. We have different interpretations of the past even if that past is shared, because forces other than the remembrance itself shape our interpretations. Here it is pertinent to cite the example of Shirosuma, a Japanese soldier who openly admitted his participation in Japanese war crimes against the Chinese during World War II. He was one of the few former soldiers of the Empire of Japan to admit to his participation in the Yixingaobaksamsubta Nanking Massacre. After his confession, he visited China 7 times to apologize and help Chinese scholars find more evidence of the Japanese soldiers' brutality. Would Azuma have objected to China celebrating our victory over Japan in World War II? I do not think so. One dominant force that shapes our interpretations of the past, or shall we say collective memory, is mainstream history. Few of us nowadays know of events that happened during World War II through personal recollection. The young people, especially, learn of events through history books, and that is why curriculums can be very political. There is nothing to be proud of in being determined solely by our past or our memory. Yet having Long as a speaker at the book fair proves one point. Contrary to what some people would have us believe, it shows that Hong Kong indeed is a free place. That is why organizers were able to invite her